Manichin, Gulf Islands.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. Madam Speaker, I'm also hearing from constituents. A wonderful local paper in my area, Island Tides, can't deliver its papers. I heard a very heartrending email from a woman who's waiting for the child support check from her ex-husband. But I also recognize that this legislation is draconian, violates union rights, and I'm deeply troubled by all this. And I'm particularly troubled, Madam Speaker, that while collective bargaining rights are what we're talking about at this moment, we don't seem to be negotiating between each other. We have a piece of legislation that clearly is not going to enjoy the support of this House. And I would ask the Minister of Labour, the Honourable Minister, if she would entertain amendments, if she would be prepared with leaders of the major parties in this House to come to an agreement so that the back-to-work legislation is fair. I particularly think, since we've put a gun to the head of the union, maybe we might want to do the same to management and demand a fixed percentage of Canada Post profits to go to QP in the future, CUPW rather. So I ask the Minister for if she's willing to entertain negotiations here.
The Honourable Minister of Labour.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. And I thank the Honourable Member for the question. Indeed, we can see that from coast to coast to coast, the work stoppage is affecting everybody. But I will point out, Madam Speaker, that this legislation does not violate anybody's right at all. This is very much within the constructs of what happens in fair collective bargaining. It is, unfortunately, the final solution with respect to the matter in that Parliament is being asked to intervene in a dispute between two individual parties, and it's a shame that it's come to this.